So we decided to extend our break just a little bit, just so we could listen to some more music, because we are
Hotel
rockers like that. We
California's
love
and the Eagles is just a classic.
Say more
Those
music, let's talk.
guitars, yeah,
No,
those guitars
yeah,
are
more
just,
music, let's talk. Let's
yeah.
talk more music. We're all about that. Now, the hashtag is RockTour254. Keep talking to us. What do you want us to play for you? We're going to be doing that. It's Halloween. It is the awards. Like, you cannot afford to be in a bad mood today. Today is just that day.
Everybody
yeah. You gotta have a great mood. The weather is just right.
Yeah.
Like, everything
Actually,
is
for
just.
me, it's really working.
You like this weather, right?
Yeah, and I just the whole week, the whole day. Yeah, today I just chomoka and I met this buddy of mine. He's like, "Wait, tukakule nyama."
And everything is
As
just
in,
working out the way
yeah,
you want.
It's just like a Christmas, you know, for us. Rockers. Just like Christmas, plans, soda, and
yeah,
kinyaji.
Yeah.
Everybody is generous. So rockers are feeling. The two rockers are feeling generous.
I can see that. Now, I talked to him at Hugh Skills at Feeling at RockTour254. And of course, tell him the hashtag RockTour254. Now, before we went on a break, we had our guests right here in studio. We have Lawrence and we have Sly. Sly
awesome
is a makeup
people.
Artist. If you like goth makeup, well, she's a creative.
I like it being defined. She's a goth man.
She's a goth makeup artist, but we insisted we're going to call her a creative because she does a lot of other things aside from just makeup. And then we have Lawrence right here, who is a cosplay, and he is also he is the founder of the Horror Fun Club Kenya, K-E. Now, Lawrence, what has been, what was the hardest costume you've ever had to either put on or just make for you?
As a cosplayer, I think the hardest costume I've gotten to wear is Venom.
Oh!
I was during the previous Nikon convention.
Yo!
Yeah.
I
would have loved to have. I wish you could see, like, maybe on your social media. Where can people find you, maybe, so that guys can check it out?
On my Instagram, at Larry_Sylvester.
Larry_Sylvester. Y'all better go out there and check what he's all about. Like, the Venom was
dope
movie. What? I loved that. Like, how was it hard? Like, putting on the costume or making it, or what was the hard part?
Being in the costume was quite a bit difficult, because, you know.
All right, yeah, that must have been really hard. So it's like, maybe you can just move slightly. All right, I think that will be so that we have some space between the two of you.
I see them.
All right, and how about a character, like, during cosplay, you had an event last year, because that was a okay, Costopia. Yeah,
yes.
That's what I'm thinking. I was thinking Zootopia. I'm like, Costopia. So during that, when you're in such an event, so if I come in a certain character, do I have to play that the whole night? I might just come, no rules. I'm thinking, like, if the event is Costopia, I like maybe Zootopia, maybe the lead character, nime dress ka bunny, nini. Do I have to play that character? How do people go about that?
Well, for most of the events, we usually state out a theme. For Costopia, it was the first horror convention in East Africa, so the theme was just horror movies. So if you come for that event, you just cosplay your best horror movie character. We had people cosplaying Edward Scissorhands. Other people are cosplaying a couple of other costumes. So basically, just, you know, do your own thing. It can be just simple, something you can do as a hobby.
Yeah.
That some people, you know, take cosplay seriously. And
the people
who
take it really seriously.
Yeah.
I have a friend of mine. He's Tanzanian. He comes to Kenya just for that. When we have events here, he comes just for that, for cosplay. Now, do you prefer cosplaying alone or solo, or do you prefer doing it in a group?
Well, I'm still a newbie in cosplay, so I just do it as a hobby. Mostly, the events I'm usually mostly the facilitator or the host.
Oh
yes.
Dog.
Yeah, but it's cool. We have a buddy who really does it, yeah?
Mtende.
He was
supposed to be here.
Seriously, as in, does so much.
He takes it a notch. He wears his metal and everything. He takes it to the next level. He takes
him
it.
He's just, yeah.
All right. Now, Sly, you have something in your hands. What are those? Maybe you can talk to us about that, yeah?
No, somebody's an artist.
Yeah, this is my artist. Oh, tell us about that.
Dragon Ball. This is a Saiyan. They're called Saiyans.
So maybe you can hold it so that the camera can get it.
Yeah, I can see
some.
I have this one. This is the last one. And then this is Mm-hmm. And this is another one. I just got it randomly off Pinterest. Pinterest is the source for every form of art.
Yeah, I gathered that piece of work.
All right.
And then this one is another one. It was actually inspiration from another artist. They are graffiti artists.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So it's Lola and the Chim. Mm-hmm. Yes. So basically, I do paint. I also do what can I call it? Okay, just basically different genres. You can do mixed media.
Mm-hmm.
You
can
use markers, you can use like everything, but as long as it's a canvas painting,
right,
or wherever you're doing it from.
Okay. Yeah. So right, so you just hold your mic closely to your, all right, yeah, that's better. Mm. So what can you say are some of the challenges you encounter in your line of work?
Actually, for painting, because I'm new, this is not something that I've been doing for a long time.
Mm.
I just probably professionally this year.
Mm.
So maybe the challenges that I can say that I've experienced is lack of materials. Because in Kenya, I don't think art is such a big thing.
Mm-hmm.
Probably the cost, like for canvases, maybe if you want, you know, you can get the unstretched ones, but then no one really has the time to go and stretch it, to go and prime it. Mm-hmm. So if you want to get a new canvas, it's quite pricey.
Mm-hmm.
And also the paints, sometimes they go out of stock, then you have to wait for a very long time.
Right.
And also the body paints, like the ones I used, sometimes they can like go out of stock for like a year. So you have nothing to use. So like, I really do not have any content.
Right, tell us about that. Is that so? That is from of your Instagram, right?
Yes, that's
right. So that is your work.
Yes.
You're the one who did that.
Yes. So, the pink one. I was going pink for Ursula.
Pink, yeah. Maybe we can have the pink one now, right on screen. The pink one. The makeup. The one with the lady.
Right,
the one
on the top right.
Yeah.
The first one on the top right.
On the top right, yeah. Let's have that so that we can check
it. That's one, yeah.
Yeah, that one. Yeah, the pink one. Tell us about that.
So that's a character from Little Mummy.
Mm-hmm.
So that's basically
for those watch cartoons.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, then maybe I can show you the Joker one, the one for the Joker, because I think that is something
that is a nice Joker.
The Joker movie just came out.
Yeah, this one is really cool.
Yeah. And
That means like you're predicting, huh?
Yeah.
Yes. So when I saw the trailer, I just thought.
You can go and do something about that. Maybe you can have the Joker one right on screen so that guys can see it. Tell us about that. Was inspired by the Joker movie before it came out.
Actually, okay, I have two different Jokers there. So we have so many Jokers. We have Joaquin Phoenix. He did the one that's currently showing.
Mm-hmm.
And then we also have the old one. So we have three other ones, of which one I'm not going to mention because people do not like him, the Jared Leto Joker. So I've never really done that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we also have Joaquin Phoenix. Maybe I can just show you if I see the image.
All right, let's have that. Can we have some of the some of our kindly? Let's have the Joker and the other one she's talking about.
On the second row and at the left.
All right, so how long does it take for you to come up with a look like this? Like if I need something like that.
Oh, okay, I can say, okay, when I was starting,
It
was quite difficult. It'd take hours. But now that I'm doing it professionally, maybe even 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
But it depends on the content and everything that's going to be done. But something basic like this, 5 minutes, you're done.
5 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay.
But after the painting, with the painting dry or that is still wet?
Yes, it's so wet. It's dry. So, and then the advantage is that it's easy to come off. So you just have to wash it. Just need soap and water.
Right.
It's water-based. So you really would not have a hard time.
So this is the one you were telling us about?
No, it's a joke. This is a monkey.
Right, let's have the Joker. Right,
I'm just painting people there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's cool. So which events do you usually go to? How do you get your clients?
Actually, I usually go to events like Comic Cons. We have Comic Cons in Kenya. We have Nikon and Movie Jabba, and now we have Sylvester. We've actually worked together for Postopia.
Yeah.
And it's really amazing for the horror characters. We even did another look with him for Jason Voorhees. But
right, that is the Joker right there on screen.
So there's the first one, the second one. The first one, that's Heath Ledger. That's he was the most, like, the legendary Joker.
The naughtiest Joker.
The best.
Yeah.
Then below, I have a friend of mine that was doing his makeup. His name is Julius, a very awesome cosplayer. He does the best costumes. And then at the bottom, the three photos, that's the Joaquin Phoenix.
Right.
The new Joker.
Mm-hmm.
So the trailer came out last year, and I thought, why not? It's going to be a hit.
But people are feeling it. Have you watched the movie, the Joker yes. movie? People are feeling it. So what's your take?
Awesome. It was too awesome. You know, it's not about the Joker. It's about like
the story. Like I remember when it started, what he had to go through, like from society.
This is just showing you. He's just not a villain.
Yeah.
There are actually things that led to that.
Yeah, to before he changed, before he changed and became who he became.
That's the deal about the movie. Yeah. I don't want to give spoilers, but
I know.
It's simply amazing.
I know. Yeah. I know, but for some other people, they thought it was too much.
Nope.
I remember. I know that the production house was like, if you think it's too much, go watch Marvel.
Yeah.
Well, it was actually.
I just have to put this out.
I was like, wow, that's really cold. That's really cold.
That was really amazing.
Yeah, that was really amazing.
Maybe they're scared or something. I don't
know. Yeah, guys was a bit scared. Like, it was too much.
Maybe Marvel were just trying to push something because this Marvel something is really competing against them big time.
Yeah.
And but that movie is awesome because it's a real life experience. It's something that the everyday person can relate to.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, you guys go check it out if you haven't already. Now, Lawrence is still here, so I'm gonna ask Lawrence. Like we're talking about cosplay, but then there's the horror fan club. You told us how it came about. Now, for someone, do you have like specific people that come through? Am I everybody's invited? What's the criteria if someone is looking to come through? Do they sign up? Tell us. Everything.
Find you.
Basically, the Horror Fan Club. We have a website where you can go sign up for free. On our website,
that's the Horror Fan Club Kenya.
Yes, the Horror Fan Club Kenya has its own website. You go there. There will be a pop-up. You just sign up for free. We get your name, and then during one of our events, we usually have tiny ID tags. So if you're a member of the Horror Fan Club, we give you that. That gives you certain pros and cons for events that we handle.
Yeah.
And you know, just keep you in the loop of
what's
the events that we are having.
What's coming up?
Right, so since the event started, since the club started, how many events have you had so far?
So far, we've had more than 5 serious ones. Yeah, the others are just like tiny meet and greets, you know, movie marathons, and people want like a themed party, we go do it for them. So we can say a little bit more than 5, but we have more than 10 events.
Right, now, do you ever get like backlash from people who don't understand?
Yeah, because the society is so religious sometimes. At a space, and for example, there's one space where we had to decorate the entire venue with like skeletons and skulls, and you know, one Uber driver was like, I don't go there because you know, these people are so you know, we have that kind of feedback from people who really don't understand the urban culture, but that's why we try to, you know, remove from people's mind. Like, this is just a genre like romance, like action,
I actually put this on my status. I don't know if Huskels, you saw it. I was telling people about that. Like, the reason why most rockers or most rock-related events have skulls, it's not even the one Huskels has. It's not because, like, it's evil. The reason why people do skulls is because, like, most rockers don't judge. And the reason why they do that, because if you have a photo of a skull, you can't tell if someone is black or white. You can't tell if they are fat or thin. You can't tell if they are tall or, like, tiny. Like, you cannot tell what kind of person it is. Like, it casts across. So the sky is just a representation of like we are one people.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. At the end of the day, we're just the same. Yeah. We all have skulls.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody has a skull. Even
the guy who got a 34 million watch. It has a scar. If it's Tomorrow and Putia and Men's Putia, nobody would know about that watch.
Right. So it's just like a representation that shows like we are all one people. And just because I like something different from what you like, it doesn't mean like
We should help each other.
Yeah.
You know.
It's just like the way it is, the way he said, maybe the way the society sees things. They're like, mimi ni Mkristo, sasa you are pana, you're a new shetani or something. Now, do you ever get that? Because you do like gothic makeup most times. So do you ever get that as well?
Yes, I get that a lot.
Do you have any one incident maybe you can tell us about?
Yes. I've actually done some makeup on my friend, Julius.
Yeah.
He actually walked from the house to the Matatu stage like that. He didn't even pay the car because they were so scared. They were freaked out. He went to a rock event.
You should come do me one.
No, he was so funny. And then myself, sometimes I do it. And then you see some very funny comments on Instagram. Oh, you shouldn't do things like that. it looks devilish, but then it's not devilish, it's creative.
Yeah.
God didn't give you the skills for nothing.
Even this was semi-devilish. Mm-hmm. Ask them to describe the devil. You don't know what the devil looks like.
Okay, it's just, you know, people are used to, people are comfortable in things they know.
Yeah, that's what I always say. People are always scared of what they don't know. Mm. People are so scared of what they do not know. Something new is going to take a while.
It's going to be something very different. People are just going to be like, okay. I even have probably maybe relatives who are like, oh.
We're lingia mali.
But the best thing is that my mom is very supportive.
Awesome. So she defends you.
She's actually my litmus paper as well. Even my brothers and my sister.
Yeah.
Oh. I do it on them. My family is very supportive.
Right. So like you guys can do this for them before Chrissy.
So how do you ensure that, let's say like you just did this on my face and then someone else maybe wants that. How do you clean your brushes? Like, do you have any procedure? Someone looking to do that, maybe how do they go about it? Because I may have a skin condition.
Yes, and then you
go do it on his face and then he gets it. How do you ensure that your brushes are like, okay?
Mm-hmm. So for brushes, even as a makeup artist, this is something you should always do, clean your brushes. Mm-hmm. So what you do after using them, especially for paint brushes, they usually go dry because of the paint.
Yeah.
So you first have to soak them. Mm-hmm. After soaking them, it's I use conditioner. Conditioner for the hair, it really cleans them.
Right.
So after using the conditioner, you just put them out to dry. That's it.
Oh.
Yeah.
All right, now for someone looking to do what you do, what advice would you give them? Are someone looking to get into maybe goth makeup, doing like shoes makeup, because she actually does that. If you need your shoes to have some sort of look, maybe some art on your shoes, yeah, she can actually do that. So what would you tell someone looking to do that?
First of all, just start. That's all you need to do first. Start. And then don't have the mentality that you need someone to push you somewhere.
Right.
I had no one.
Yeah.
I had YouTube and Instagram. And it really taught me a lot. Yeah.
Right.
Because if you wait for people to teach you, no one... People are afraid to teach others because they fear that you'll take their jobs.
Yeah.
But then there are a lot of jobs for everyone out here. So just start and use what you have. Actually been advised by a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's a very bad camera, use that one. Because when you use that one and you start with that, that's how you'll get even the money to buy new equipment. So just start.
Mm-hmm.
And ask questions. Never be afraid to ask. People are afraid to ask. Mm. Yes.
All right. That's awesome. Now we're gonna talk to Lawrence for a while before you wind up because time is not on our side. Lawrence, so what's the best thing about doing what you do? What do you love most about what you do? Like being a cosplay and also just being the founder of the Horror Fun Club and having other enthusiasts come through and just share the same goal. What's the fun part about that? The most amazing part about it?
I think the most amazing part about it is getting to meet new people from different walks of life.
Because,
you know, what I do really cuts across every demographic from kids to like really old people. So, you know, selling your ideal to them and them being receptive of it, that's like really amazing for me. Like when you come for an event and you like it, I'm like, wow. When you call us to your house and you want us to plan your black themed wedding, they're like, wow, perfect. That connection is what we usually treasure most.
That's what you treasure most, your client satisfaction.
Yes.
Right. Now, so when you have your events, like let's say you had Costopia. Like I don't know why I can't get that. Now, so do you usually have a panel to judge like the best looks or the worst looks, or how do you go about it?
Yes, we usually have an in-house team that is very fair and that judges the costumes based on, you know, what has been put in there and just everything. You know, so it's not something, sometimes you even have audience voting for you know, like the best thing that is on screen.
You have like maybe like on Facebook Live or something. So so you post all the looks and then you have people choose which one they like the most.
Yes.
All right. So when is the next event? How much does it cost? Who is invited? Tell us everything.
All right. For our second annual Costopia event, the Horror Convention, will be next year. Dates will be announced on our Instagram pages and Facebook pages at Horror Fan Club Kenya. But during the course of the year, we usually have tiny events like meet and greets and horror movie marathons, which are usually posted on the page. But for next week we will be on the scene for at various institutions like at the Village Market, at Car in the Hub, you know, just hanging out, you know, just
right. And I had a rumor there's an event you guys are doing with Hugh Skills. Is that correct?
Yeah, so something might be coming up. Mm-hmm. Guys, you can just what can I tell you? Look out for Zombieland. If you're interested in watching Zombieland at Zombieland. Saturday's Prize.
Yeah. And if you're a fan of horror movies, this is your guy. So this is your time.
You've had this horror convention.
Tell people where they can find you, how they can sign up, so that when Zombieland comes out, maybe they can come join you, so that you can watch it together. Mm-hmm. And that should be next week, right?
Yeah, this should be next week.
It's coming out next week.
We should just check out our pages. Check out. I'll be posting it mostly by Monday, if not tomorrow.
Right.
And then we'll know what to do with it. But basically, it's something that's going down. Mm-hmm. You're going to watch Zombieland.
Is it right? So we're going to tell you.
I know Wednesday is the right date for Halloween, yeah?
It's Thursday.
It's Thursday? Yeah,
Halloween is on Thursday.
Oh, Thursday. So that will be the eve.
So Wednesday or Thursday,
the eve before Thursday. Mm.
So
the eve of Halloween,
or both days. You can we'll see what we'll do.
It's a, you are rockers, you can never have many parties.
We're just flexible.
You
no
can't
limits,
have enough
no
parties.
Yeah,
yeah. The more the merrier, yeah?
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so you're going to tell us where people can find you and when the next event is, where is it going to be, if they're looking to watch Zombieland with you.
you can visit our website at www.mindrealmreality.com.
Okay, say that one more time. Just
www.mindrealmreality.
Oh, Mind Realm.
Mind Realm Reality.
Yeah.
.webly.com. Mm-hmm. Or on our Instagram page, Horror Fan Club Kenya. Mm-hmm. Or on Facebook, To a Fault, because we love horror to a fault.
Oh, To a Fault.
Yes.
To a Fault, Mind Realm,
Mind Realm
Reality.
Yeah.
And Horror Fan Club Kenya. So if you miss one, you can miss all three of them.
Yeah.
If you just
hear,
miss all three of them.
We'll be posting the details for our next event there.
Right. Mm-hmm. So what are your last remarks before we let you go? What would you tell the guys at home or someone who's just like finding out about this for the first time? What would you say?
I would tell them to feel free to contact us. Feel free to ask us anything and engage us in something that you would deem out of this world. We'd like offering immersive and out-of-this-world experiences. So if you're looking for that, please do hit us up and we'll get back to you.
Awesome. And how about you? Your last comments as we wind up?
What I can say is people should maybe... Okay, for his event, actually influences what I do as well.
Yeah.
So maybe if people actually try to open up their minds and see and venture into other things, you'd actually find it's something that you might be interested in. So be open-minded.
Right.
Basically, yeah.
Okay. Be open-minded. That's what she's going to leave us with. Be open-minded. But it's good to be open-minded. Just try new things. Actually, someone was asking me, when was the last time you did something for the first time?
What was your answer?
I was like, can I think about it and then get back to you?
I know.
And and that would be awesome.
But then that's nice because it was a challenge. Now you
Now I have to think about it. I'm like, time to try new things.
I thought you'd be like, define something.
All right, so we're going to do this. A big shout out to Felix Flex Muruku. And it's my big up Hugh Skills, always killing it. I love Amos Nkrumah, as always, he's tuned in from Ruaka, yay, shout out to you. And then you have Amos Mose, and it's my tuned in from Nakuru. I love Mbeka Miringu, and it's my watching from Isich, yes. He says, not into Halloween vibe, but to each his own. play me any What I've Done by Linkin Park. Yeah. Right, so we're going to be doing that. Hugh Skills is still here, he's going to be playing you more music. Right about now, is that time we take a very short break. We're coming right back. Stay here. Keep it rock tour, keep it Y254.